Hello and welcome to today's webinar about the new VSTX export add-on for WAV files for HTML. Thanks for joining in. I hope everyone can hear me and see my screen. My name is Lucas. This is me. This is the team behind the VSTX export. I'm a software developer here at WAVWorks for the WAV files for HTML product and for the VSTX export. For your interest, this webinar will be recorded and uploaded later on YouTube. So if you miss anything, you can rewatch it later. This webinar will be split into two parts. In the first part, I will give an introduction and an overview over the VSTX export. And this part will be without any programming stuff. And in the second part, I will dive into how to program with the VST export, and we will have a live coding session. After both parts, there will be a short questions and answers section where you can ask questions. If you have any questions, go ahead and post them into the chat. I will try to answer them as good as I can. In the first part, I will quickly explain what VSTX actually is for those of you who don't know. I will give some motivation why you would use VSTX if you have already WAV files. I will give a short overview over the VSTX export and its features. I will quickly show how to set it up. And then in the second part, I will explain the VSTX shape model with shapes and pages and the like, and how you program with the VSTX export. And then afterwards, there will be a live coding session where I will show how you can use VSTX stencils as templates for your WAV files graphs. Rather for the VSTX files you create. Okay, then let's start. What is Microsoft VSTX? It's basically a diagram editor where you can create graphs like flowcharts, org charts, floor plans, and anything you can imagine. You can bind your data to these diagrams, and they can dynamically update according to the data. And VSTX has some support for automatic layouts, but they are quite restricted in comparison to the WAV files layouts. I can quickly show you how VSTX looks like. It's a diagram editor where you can drag and drop some shapes and maybe connect them with connectors. That's how they call edges. That's VSTX. The file format of VSTX is VSTX, and for the stencil files, it's VSSX. So why would you need this VSTX export add-on? First of all, you can create VSTX diagrams from your data while using WAV files powerful visualization and layout features. Or You might want to share your Wi-Fi diagrams with customers or other departments or business partners that don't have Wi-Fi and who need visio files. Or you might need to integrate Wi-Fi into existing business processes relying on visio. Or you might need to process Wi-Fi diagrams with tools that require visio files as input. So these are some use cases. I think everyone might have their own reason why they would need the visio export in, together with Wi-Fi. So what is the VSDX export? It's a new add-on for Wi-Fi for HTML. It has to be purchased separately, and it requires a Wi-Fi for HTML license. If you're interested in the export, go ahead and contact our sales team. They will gladly help you. What does the export do? Well, it basically converts Wi-Fi diagrams to visio files. And for most graphs, it works automatically and is very fast and very easy to set up. But it can also be fully customized to fit any special requirements. The export produces very high quality visio files, so it preserves the graph structure, which means you can edit the graphs further in visio. And it also can convert the item styles you use in Wi-Fi to visio shapes. There you have basically three options. Either you can use the automatic conversion, which only works for SVG styles. As a second option, you can import visio stencils and use the masses and style sheets within as blueprints for the single graph items. Or as a third option, you may also completely programmatically create the styles. So now I'm gonna show you a demo. This is the demo you can also find online. We have a graph here. I can switch between, in this case, two graphs, and I can press the export button, and this will create me a visio file. And as you can see, the graph basically looks exactly like in Wi-Fi. And if you want, you can also edit this file, copy some notes, you can move them around, you can create new edges if you want. Give it some color. So that's about the visio files the export or the add-on produces. Here are some features that are interesting for developers. We have great IDE support. The add-on seamlessly integrates with your IDE. We have some source code demos. We have a developer's guide that explains all the details you need to know to program with the add-on. And we have an API documentation in the documentation viewer you are used from the other Wireworks products. You can find the demo I just showed you and the developer's guide and the API documentation online if you want. here is some code. This is the only code in part one I will show you, promised. The Wi-Files for HTML product, this add-on also comes as NPM module, so you can simply add the add-on to your dependencies in your package.json, and you can afterwards import your the export using E6 style module imports. So the add-on is very simple and fast to set up. The only thing it requires are these five lines here. You can create a new export, then call the write blob method, pass it your graph component, and then afterwards you receive a file that you can save using your custom library for file saving. So we've already reached the end of part one. If there are any questions, you can post them into the chat. There's one question. Can the Visio files also be opened in Visio Viewer? Yes, of course they can. The files created by the add-on can be opened in any compliant Visio Viewer, like for example, the Visio Desktop, like I showed earlier, or the Visio Online version, or of course the Visio Viewer plugin for Internet Explorer. There's another question. Will this feature come for other platforms as well? Currently, this is not planned, and it's definitely not a trivial task. This is basically, it basically depends on the customer demand if we will bring this for the other platforms as well. There's another question from E6 only. Currently, the export is targeted for E6. You need to use E6 style imports. The reason is that we depend on third-party libraries that need to be bundled together with the VSTX export and your user code. And for this reason, there is currently no UMD variant. But the VSTX add-on comes basically as ES5 code with the only E6 part, the only E6 part is the imports and exports. Getting it to work in a ES5 context should not be too difficult. Okay, so there are no further questions as far as I can see. Okay, there's another question that just popped in. Can you add a page to the VSDX with additional details like graph details? Yes, you can, of course. If that's okay, I would answer this question more detailedly in the second Q&A section, and then I will maybe have some code I can show you. Maybe a colleague can provide some code then. Okay, so I guess there are no further questions. Then I will go ahead with the second part. In this part, I will explain the Visio shape model and how to program with the add-on. And I will show you how to use Visio stencils. The Visio model, Visio diagrams consist of single shapes, like you can see here. And these shapes may also be organized in group shapes, which are basically normal shapes with the addition of this, they have child shapes. Shapes have properties like width and height, color, line width, whatever you can imagine, which define how the shape actually looks like. And these properties can also be described through formulas. So I could, for example, say if I want this shape to be one third as wide as the group shape containing it, I could say width is sheet one, which is the group shape, exclamation mark width. So I select the width of the group shape and multiply it with 0.3. Important concept is that shapes can inherit properties from masters and style sheets. Masters are basically blueprints for a shape, and style sheets define the color and style of the shape. So how do we translate Wi-Fi's graphs to Visio shapes? Say we have a node with a label and an edge, a self-loop edge, and two ports. This is translated to a connector shape for the edge. Connector shapes are basically edges, if you put it in Wi-Fi's terms. We have a shape for the ports, and these shapes contain a connection. Connections are basically the logical logical ports in Visio, and the edge is glued to this connection, so it moves together with the port and the connection. Um, Then the node is realized as a container shape that contains the shape for the actual node visualization and a shape for the label. Okay, so I will now show you a little code. This is the callback here that gets called when you press, when you press the export button here. And yeah, what it does is, you've seen this already earlier, we create a new VSDX export, call the write blob method, pass it our graph component. Then we have a blob, and we save this blob under this file name, which we pick from this box here. What you didn't see earlier is you can also pass it a configuration. This is basically equivalent to omitting this parameter. And with this configuration, you can configure the export. And the configuration has some properties like the page size or the margins or scale, for example. And it also has two lists, master providers and chip processing steps. These lists are configured to pipelines, I will now explain, where you can configure how the single graph items are converted to Visio shapes. So the master provider pipeline is responsible for providing one master and one or several style sheets. And the shape processing pipeline is responsible for giving the shapes the actual properties. So if we, for example, the export encounters a node, it queries the master provider's pipeline, one master provider after another, until one of them doesn't return null, but returns a master and style sheets object. Any master provider that comes after this one will not be queried. So once we have the master and the style sheets, the export creates a shape and applies this master and the style sheets. So then we have a raw shape that still lies on the 0,0 origin and probably doesn't look much like the shape we have in mind. So it is piped through another pipeline, the shape processing step pipeline, and each shape processing step will be called once with this shape, and they may assign any properties like its location or the dimensions, some style properties. And after this pipeline, the shape is complete and it should look exactly like in Y files. Okay, so let's dive into coding. Uh, yeah, in order to use Visual Stencils for our export, say we want not the screens with the blue background, but the ones with the red screens, then we can go ahead and import a stencil that has red screens. I can show you the stencil quickly. Here it is. It's basically a computer with a red screen. I can drop it onto the page. So in order to achieve this, we have to add some code here. I'm not gonna go ahead and type this manually. I just copy it. First I have to load the stencil file. I have it here. And then we have to create a ESSX stencil provider factory. And this provider factory accepts the stencil file and can now create master providers that provide these masters from the stencil and map them to Wi-Fi styles. So we add the master providers or extend the master providers pipeline by a new master provider that we create from the factory and tell it it shall apply the computer master that is in the stencil to any string template node style. And afterwards, we have to set the evaluate formulas to property to true. What this does is it turns the formula interpreter on, and the VSDX file format has one drawback. When you open a VSDX file, the VSDX doesn't evaluate any or every formula from scratch. So instead, it looks up the already calculated values that are also in the serialized in the file and displays them. So this means that we have to evaluate any formulas during the export already. All master providers and shape processing steps that come with the export, apart from this one here, don't require the interpreter. Instead, they manually calculate all the values. But if you want to write your own master providers or use, for example, this this VSS Extensible Provider Factory, you need to turn this on. So if we go back to our application, it's currently reloading. And we press the export button again. We hopefully see a VSDX file with red screens. Yep. Success. So, yeah, we imported a Visio stencil and mapped all string templates or all nodes with a string template style to this new master from the template. And of course, the nodes now all look the same because, yeah, we didn't differentiate between, like, for example, the server computer here or a regular screen. Yeah, okay. Then we come to the second Q&A session, and I already saw there are a few questions. There is one question. Is there any problems with SVG items which colors are set as RGBA, so with alpha? Early when we export our graph in SVG, we had a problem with colors with opacity. As far as I know, it should work fine, but I'm not 100% sure. But yeah, I suppose it should work as expected. Okay, another question. Is there plans to support custom arrows? Currently, this is not supported and currently not planned, but yeah, we might implement it. It shouldn't be too difficult. Okay, another question. What's the default page size? The default page size fits the graph. So if you have a large graph, the page will be large. And if you have a small graph, the page will be small. You can always set it to a fixed value if you want. Yeah. Okay, so we had a question earlier. Can you add a page to the VSTX export with additional details like graph details? Yes, you can. And my colleague, as far as I can see, looked up some code snippet we had somewhere where we add a company logo. I can maybe try and make this paste it in here. So what you have to do is you have to add a listener to the configuration, and this listener is called after the export is finished. And before or right before the package gets serialized. So there you can go ahead and modify anything you want. For example, like add additional pages or load a or add a company logo or something like that. Let me see if I have a logo somewhere here. We can take the VXX export logo and copy it here. Then we have to it's already there. We have to fetch the image and can afterwards get the page we want to put it on, create a image shape. So we create a foreign shape. And foreign shapes are basically shapes for images or any other foreign data. Then we create an actual image, pass it the format, which is simply a string like PNG in this case. And pass it also the data. The data is a string which contains the image data as binary. We have to give the image some dimensions. How large is it? 300 times 94. So we have 300 times 94. Then here's already a conversion function. All dimensions in Visio are given in inches, so we have to convert those pixel values to inches. And so let's assign those properties to the image. The IDE used some different shortcuts as I'm used to, so I mistyped. I just saw that a colleague completed the snippet already completely. So let's paste it there. Okay, this is now duplicate. So let's go over the lines quickly. Or maybe we can test it if it already works. Well, it's not defined. Where is yeah, we have to put in AR, of course. This should be public. Let's copy the file name. And let's compile. Okay. So see. Yes, okay, so we have the logo on the bottom right. Okay. Yeah, so I can quickly explain what we did here. Yeah, we assign the width and height, also assign it to the image width and height. And what we here have is a formula, which basically says the image width shall be it's as wide as the width of the shape. And here's one feature of the add-on that's quite comfortable. You don't have to write the formulas manually as strings and put all the references like, I don't know, shape sheet one dot, I don't know, but you can simply use a tag template string, which will automatically resolve your references. And yeah, what we also did, if we export it again, as you can see, the logo always stays in the bottom right of the page. And how we did that is we assigned a function to the pin X value. Pin X and Y define the location of the shape. And yeah, we assign a formula that basically sets the pin X to the page width minus the width of the shape and subtract some margins. And every time something changes on the page, like the page width, this Visio evaluates this formula and puts the shape into the right place. Okay, now you got some insight into how you can program with the export. Let me check if there are any further questions. Okay. Yeah. I could check if the RGBA color works for this. I could change. Where is my template? I'm currently not completely sure. It's in the GraphML file. Okay, so it's quite complicated. I suppose it should work. If not, write us a bug report. Okay, then I suppose there are no more questions. So we've come to the end of the webinar. Thanks for watching and happy diagramming. And if you as I already said, if you missed something, you can rewatch it later on YouTube. We have recorded this webinar and we're going to upload it on YouTube. Okay, thanks for watching and bye-bye.